Stay calm, man. Ma'am.
Flying over the middle of the Rubicali Desert, looking for some lost city in the sand. Next thing I know, plane's going down. I'm hanging like a rag doll at 30,000 feet, just trying to hold on.
And a plague on every corner. When half the city hated me, and the other half wanted me dead. He brought out my good side.
Tell him your war has changed. So you do what you have to. I'm no hero. But whatever good I've done, it was him.
It was in the days of suffering when the gods made their might known. When no mortal dared stand up to Zeus, he did.
Omaha! Pinned down on that godforsaken beach. Thinking if I lay there, I'll maybe die. But if I get up, there ain't no maybe about it. Then one man broke through. Michael!
Michael.
Michael.
When the Templars murdered my family.
When the whole bloody world's gone crazy.
Hellcat, Sector 9.
To Michael.
Michael!
For all he does.
For all of us. To Michael.
To Michael! To Michael! To Michael!
Hello and welcome to Dose of D-Pad Podcast, the swag capital of the world. And I'm excited right now. There's not really any important news at all besides that new Grand Theft Auto 5 trailer that came out today. But I'm excited because I'm going to pay off my PS4 early. So I don't have to wait until November and have no money and be like, oh, I'm in debt. How fun! So yeah, I'm gonna pay it off early. That's my final decision. I'm excited. I mean, next generation of consoles is feeling more real than ever, and that's really exciting for me. I'm highly anticipating the release of the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. I was skeptical of Xbox One, as many of you know, due to the extreme bias on our site. Luckily, there are a few Xbox lovers that write for our site. I wouldn't call them fanboys, because that is not an appropriate term, I don't think. But there are a few Xbox lovers that write for our site, and I'm glad that they were there during my time of my time of excitement, I shall say, during E3, when I was a little too overwhelmed by all the hubbub. So yeah, I'm excited. I'm ready. As Reggie Filame would say, my body is ready.
Top-ranking games of the week.
This week's top-ranking games of the week are, well, the top-ranking game of the week, I should say, is The Last of Us. Yet again, not surprising at all. I gave The Last of Us an 8.3 during my review. It has a 95.05% on GameRankings.com. I don't disagree with any of the reviews that I've read so far about The Last of Us. I actually saw a 6.0. I still agreed with that. I can't say I agree with all these 10s that it's getting, but I understand where the reviewers are coming from in their reviews. I understood the 6.0. I understand these 8s and 9s that it's getting. It's very mixed in my own opinion. The writing and the emotion conveyed in the game were really great. They That's where Naughty Dog went right, but I think they went wrong in the gameplay and the boring aesthetics that certainly ruined the game at points for me. The frustration of getting through a certain part just to get to another cutscene, and then realizing that that one part of the game, that the game was flawed in that way, where you didn't really want to play the game at points, and you just wanted to get to another cutscene, and then it felt like, well, why is this a game? And you start to question that, and that was the negative, the negative portion of The Last of Us. Number two is Company of Heroes 2 for PC, an 81.0%. Number three is War Game Airland Battle PC, 83.44%. I'm not talking about these because I don't think they're too important right now. These are the kind of games that will come and go on game rankings. Neverwinter on PC is 74.18%. Project X Zone on the 3DS is a 70.78%. State of Decay, I've heard a lot about this, but it's at a 78.96%. Animal Crossing New Leaf, our website finally reviewed that yesterday, thanks to James Daly. He gave it a 10 out of 10. It's his opinion, so let's leave that as it is. 86.97%. I respect him completely, by the way. Leisure Suit Larry, reloaded on PC, is 63.70%. Number 9 is Deadpool, 68.15%. I thought I was going to really like Deadpool. Like, I see a lot of bad reviews, but then I see people who still like the game, and they're like, yeah, this is still worth playing, because it's funny. I start playing it, oh, God. It's not very fun at all. The gameplay is so bad that the humor isn't worth the levels. Like, the level design is so bland and so generic that it's not even worth playing. Number 10 is Fire Emblem Awakening on 3DS. I've heard this is great. It's 92.52%.
Dev quotes.
And then this week's dev quote is a quote by Miyamoto, the president of Nintendo. Or, no. Hold on. Miyamoto. The president of Nintendo is Iwata. I'm not sure why. Hold on. Okay, no. Miyamoto is the Nintendo senior managing director, and the quote is that they underestimated the cost of HD development for the Wii U. It's obvious, it's very apparent at this point that the Wii U is struggling in third-party support, and even first-party support at this point, because the even Nintendo's titles that they're working on for the Wii U have been delayed numerous times, and they're going through the same thing that Sony and Microsoft and a lot of third-party developers went through back in 2005-2006 when they were first starting to develop for HD consoles, and they didn't realize that how much difference the high-resolution games would cost to make. And it's not just because of the resolution, it's more because of the textures and the details and design. But you need a lot more artists, you need a lot more designers, you need manpower to make a game. And when the games become more detailed and more fluid and more realistic-like, you need to expand your teams. And I guess Nintendo have not played the Xbox 360 and PS3 since 2005 and 2006 respectively, and I really don't know what's up with them, but they're really out of the loop right now. They're like 6-7 years behind. They're working on a console that's as powerful as these 7-year-old consoles, which, you know, you don't really need a lot of power to run good Nintendo games, but third parties aren't going to support it for long, and they're already ceasing to support the Wii U. The only real loyal developer at this point, our publisher for the Wii U is Ubisoft, and I just can't see, as great as Watch Dogs looks, I can't see it being as good on Wii U. And then in the future, when there's more games like this, say Watch Dogs 2 and the next Far Cry title, I don't think those kind of games could run on the Wii U, especially as they get more, like the game worlds become larger, and I just can't see that kind of development working with the Wii U. And so they're going through the same struggle that publishers and developers went through years and years ago, and they're just too late, you know? Hold on, let me make sure that's not intervening with anything. No, it isn't. I can still talk about this. So, Nintendo, I can see down the road them finally catching up. They've been playing catch-up this whole time, but they haven't caught up. That's the problem. There's nothing wrong with a great game of catch-up, because Android and iOS are constantly catching up with each other in various ways, and that's great. It pushes competition and stuff, but at least with those operating systems, they're actually catching up. With Nintendo, they catch up to seven-year-old consoles 7 years after they release. Like, they finally got the strength of a 720p console that's going to run all games in 720p for the most part. It's never going to be powerful enough to run a decent 1080p game unless they lower the details and resolutions, unless it's something like Rayman Legends, which would probably be 1080p. But it's a 2D game, so it's easy to do. But I just can't see... I can see them, like, 3 years from now releasing maybe something... Like, if this was me... Anyway, hold on, I'm thinking. Last night I received a question on Ask.fm. If you don't know what that is, it's like a bunch of people can ask you questions, or you can select randomly generated questions and answer them, and everyone sees them. It's like a social networking thing. Anyway, I received a question that said, what company would I like to own if I could own any company? I picked Nintendo of America, because I feel like anyone could turn them around at this point. I think Nintendo just needs to take a loss with the Wii U, hurry up, start working on their next console now, have it out 3 years from now, have it exceed the Xbox One and the PS4 in hardware specifications and features, come out with something truly innovative to go along with the advanced hardware, something that doesn't require extra development time for developers, because that's another factor into why developers aren't making games for the Wii U, is they feel like they need to use the Wii U's gamepad screen when they really don't. They could just port the game to the Wii U without using any features on the screen and just having that blanked out. But then that would start a precedence, and more developers would begin doing that and not utilizing the screen, and then what's the point of the Wii U? But come up with something truly innovative like the Wii was, but not with motion controls, not where I have to get up and move my butt around, because I don't want to do that. I want to play a game with story-driven elements and like immersive features where I don't have to get up, where I can just sit down like I'm watching a movie. And I think that would be great if Nintendo could finally come up with something innovative, but also advanced enough to keep up with the competition. Because they're saying, Nintendo says that the Xbox One and the PS4 are not their competition, then who is? Because no matter who they're trying to compete with right now, they're not doing it. Whether they're trying to compete with Apple with the iPad, they're not even affecting Apple's sales with the iPads. So they better get their crap together and start working on some hardware that actually works, or they're just going to be a software producing company, which they've already said they don't want to be. So they just need to start working. Just start working on it and improving improving upon the console they currently have, and then including backwards compatibility in the next console, and release it early. Catch it early on. 2 to 3 years from now, I say we should get the next Wii U, or the next, not Wii U, we don't want the next Wii U. We want the next Nintendo system that can actually compete, and that would be great. A console where that's not a companion console, a console that we only need one of. We don't need a PlayStation 4 or Xbox One to go along with the system. We need just this system. Whether who knows what that's going to be, you know?
Direct Xbox.
Microsoft has detailed Xbox One's reputation system, explaining that if you're a player who constantly plays unfairly online or harass other players, you'll be forced to play with others who are just like you. So basically, if you're cheating or constantly ruining the experience for everyone else, you're going to be put in a server where with others just like you who also ruin everyone's fun. I think this is a good idea, as long as it's enforced properly. Don Matrick must have Don Matrick must have pulled the short end of the stick on the Xbox One's reputation system, because last week the president of the interactive entertainment business at Microsoft left for a CEO position at Zynga, the social game service provider that continues to disrupt my daily Facebooking. While no one knows for certain why Matrick left Microsoft, my killer instinct tells me that this may have something to do with the way he chose to market the Xbox One's digital rights management policies by telling one reporter that for consumers who don't have internet access, they may want to stick with their Xbox 360s. And my theory that I wrote down and I just read to you has already been proven false, because Don Matrick was actually really good friends with the former CEO of Zynga, and they went on bike rides or something together, some weird crap, and so he's been working towards getting a CEO position there for a long time. He makes crap load of money there. I think it says $11 million a year or something is what he's going to gross at Zynga. That's incredibly high. I'm jealous of the guy, but he's not a very pleasant person, it doesn't seem. Titanfall has won the Game Critics Awards Best of Show. I don't care. And the reason I don't care, I don't want to sound like a jerk when I say that. I don't want to stop right there and say I don't care and move on, because I don't care because I don't want to be on a game that's forced multiplayer, that has no single player mode, because it seems like it's kind of limiting creativity there. Instead of the developers being creative, we had to be creative with ourselves. And I feel like the games industry has pushed further than that, and that we no longer have to, it's not that we don't have to think for ourselves, but I think that games like The Last of Us and games like Bioshock Infinite and games that really push story elements further are more important than these kind of games where it's like forced multiplayer, like chaotic survival things. I don't think that's important anymore. I don't think that's relevant anymore now that we have these kind of games that push story and push emotion and stuff like that. I think that kind of thing really encourages players to want to go out and make their own games. And that's important. That's an important part of the game industry, is to make people want to still make games. Obviously. But I don't think these kind of games make people want to play. I don't think multiplayer really makes people want to make games. I think it just makes them want to sit on their butts all day and play games. And I don't think that's as important in the games industry anymore. I think that is a thing of the past. I think that's current gen. And I think next gen is really going to push story elements and really going to push these gameplay aesthetics and single player mode and really push emotion and cinematography and all kinds of things that we're going to start to feel like we're playing interactive movies rather than video games, and whether you like that or not, that's the way it's going to be, because that's the future. And I think there'll still be games that feel like games, but they're going to be indie games, and they're going to be much smaller, maybe not indie games, but much smaller, like downloadable purchases, exclusive downloads on the PlayStation Store and Xbox Marketplace. Xbox executive Albert Pinello, I think that's how you pronounce it, has stated that comparing console specifications is meaningless, says the guy promoting the console with the lower console specifications. Woo! The Xbox One is reportedly launching in Japan in early 2014. That's right, they're still doing that. Square Enix has explained that Final Fantasy X HD is not coming to the Xbox 360 due to Xbox Live's policies which restrict cross-platform play. Square Enix is producing the... hold on, this is not Final Fantasy X HD. I don't know why I wrote that. It's Final Fantasy 14, and it's the MMO game that is relaunching for the PlayStation 3, PS4, and PC, and they're all going to be cross-platform, but Xbox Live doesn't support cross-platform online play, so Xbox players would play on their own server, and the creator of that game does not want that to be that way. He doesn't want Xbox players to be separate from PC, PS3, and PS4. It'd be way cooler if they included everyone, but Xbox Live's policies restrict that for some reason, and there's no way of getting by it.
PlayStation Nation.
1 million people have registered to test the new Final Fantasy 14 relaunch. I'm clapping on my own because I'm the only one in the room. President and CEO of Sony Computer Entertainment of America, Jack Trenton, has claimed that Microsoft's reversal on their Xbox One consoles, DRM, digital rights management, restrictions on used games, and required internet access, was a move that was better late than never. Trenton also said that Sony's E3 press conference was not tailored towards Microsoft's earlier announcements, and that Sony, a multi-billion dollar corporation, has to make those types of decisions months and months ahead of time. So in other words, Sony didn't purposely emphasize certain parts of certain aspects of their E3 press conference, such as the one where they highly emphasized that there was no use game restrictions and no online DRM. No, they didn't do that at all. That was already planned months and months ahead of time, right? I don't know what I'm talking about. Sony has trademarked PlayStation TV, a trademark that was previously filed in 2006, but dropped in 2012, and now reinvigorated in 2013. I don't know what PlayStation TV is, but it sounds cray. They're just kind of trying to compete with the Xbox One, and who can blame them? You know, they've surpassed, their reputation has certainly surpassed that of the Xbox One. Why not just compete in every way possible and succeed? And I don't blame them. Final Fantasy X and X-2 will be receiving a new 30-minute dramatic ending for the HD remakes that are coming this year, exclusively to the PS3 and PS Vita consoles. It has been confirmed that cross-save will be supported between PlayStation 3 and Vita for those who purchase the games on both platforms. Keep in mind that the two games are packaged together on PS3, while they must be purchased separately on Vita. Danganronpa, Triple Happy Havoc, and Demon Gaze are becoming localized for the United States and Europe and will both release in 2014 on the PlayStation Vita. They very much look like generic RPGs to me, but who am I to judge? GameStop has sold out of... Wait, who am I to judge? I am the judge. And GameStop has sold out of PlayStation 4 pre-orders. So if you want a PlayStation 4 or Xbox One by Christmas, pre-order now. I've already mentioned this on Facebook to my friends, but you need to pre-order now because there's no chance you're going to just hop off and get one in November when they release.
Leave luck to heaven.
Nintendo has attempted to retrieve rights to WiiU.com earlier last week, but the case's arbitrator has stated that Nintendo has no right to the currently useless site. Someone is about to receive an abundance of cash from Nintendo. Spelunker is now available on Wii U and 3DS, but is really bad still. Fans have petitioned Nintendo's region locking on Wii U and 3DS, but Nintendo President Satoru Iwata has responded by saying that each region around the world has its own legal restrictions in regards of how games are sold, and which ones can be sold in that area, although Nintendo is the only remaining major console manufacturer that currently supports region locking across the console's entire current and upcoming library. Nintendo has announced two new Pokemon X and Y themed 3DS XLs, and a little sword Pokemon too, by the way. The Pokemon isn't exclusive to Japan, but the 3DS XLs are exclusive to Japan, and they look awesome. Unfortunately, we cannot import these special edition consoles, as they wouldn't support our localized NTSC games in our area. Well, in my area, at least, unless you're in the PAL region, in which I have no idea how it works.
Elite Machines.
Steam now allows you to link your account with Twitch TV, a move that is possible by Valve's earlier partnership with Twitch TV made this month. Final Fantasy VII is now available on Steam. It is $11.49, I believe. RuneScape 3 will launch on July 22nd, 2013, for those who still care. Asus has made their 31.5-inch, oddly specifically sized 4K monitor available for pre-order, and it only cost the lovely value of $3,500. What a bargain! EA predicts that the next tablets will have PS3-quality graphics capabilities. Too bad people are too busy playing their Atari 2600-quality Candy Crush to notice. Google is reportedly developing an Android games console. Whoop-dee-doo. Hello, Ouya.
Discussion topic of the week.
And our discussion topic this week is, how can AAA games be saved? No, and I don't mean how can you save their data. I mean, how can AAA games be rescued in this wonderful, interesting industry that's going on right now? Because certain sources, gamesindustry.biz, believe that indie games are in and AAA blockbuster games are out. I, for one, don't agree, because we've received the revenue information for The Last of Us today, and it's sold 3.4 million copies in its first month, and that's exclusive to the PlayStation 3. Video games! Hooray! Gamesindustry.biz says that charging more for games won't rescue AAA. And that is an article by Rob Fay. You should definitely check it out. It's a great article. But anyway, it makes sense. It makes sense in the article. Because, hold on. Because, it's talking about how these AAA publishers think they're going to up the price to get more money for AAA games, because a lot of AAA games aren't actually making profit right now. And that isn't because they're not selling for enough money. It's because they don't have a large enough audience yet. Obviously, these people are not realizing that their audience is still fairly niche, and that they need to target a more mainstream audience. And, I mean, that's highly important for AAA development, because people aren't, not everyone wants to play these first-person shooters, not everyone wants to play even third-person action games or whatnot. There needs to be more variety in genre when it comes to video games. We need more games like Beyond Two Souls, like Heavy Rain, because these kind of games are really gonna, broaden the audience of AAA games, and that's what's going to save the AAA game industry, is games like that. So The Last of Us is great. I mean, that's a great push towards that sort of theme. And I mean, they have a lead female character. That's a that really helps, because we need more girls and women playing games, for one. We have enough. I'm sure there are a lot of, I think it's like 40% of people who play games are girls or something, but it's, they're not playing these kind of games. They're not playing these large AAA blockbuster games. They're probably playing on their phones. They may be playing, I know a lot of girls play The Legend of Zelda. A lot of girls play Animal Crossing's huge right now for the female demographic. And I think, but those aren't AAA games. None of those are AAA games. They don't have these huge, like, $100 million budgets like The Last of Us and BioShock Infinite do. To save those kind of games, they're going to need to broaden the audience to make them more appealing to girls and women, and the marketing is going to need to improve in an abundance, because the marketing for games right now is horrible. Especially towards girls and women, especially towards that female demographic, because the marketing that we do have is so macho that it hurts, and that's not what we need right now. We don't want guys from 17 to 35, just like that's the only audience, or from 12 to 35 or something, just those are the only people playing games. We want old people to play games. We want young people to play games. We want women to play games. We want girls to play games. We want everyone to play games. It is not a restricted, it should not be this restricted niche that it is. And I almost was turned away from games for that reason, because I mean, I wanted to get into movies. I wanted to make movies, but something about, I went back and I got a Vita and I played games. I got a Vita for music. That was it. And I played Uncharted Golden Abyss. Never played a game like that before. I never played an Uncharted game. I never played this cinematic experience that, I just never seen anything like this before. And that was even one of the worst Uncharted games, even though there's not really any bad Uncharted game. But I realized then that games had much more potential than people make them out to be. People make them out as this ultra-violent experience that, because that's all you see. All you see is these Call of Duties that make crap load of money every year, that make more than any movie ever and whatnot every year. That's all you see, but you don't see these games as much, like The Last of Us, like BioShock Infinite, Heavy Rain, like I don't know. I can't think back. Uncharted. You don't see as much advertising as you should for those. Infamous Second Son. I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. But we really need to push forward and push to a mainstream audience. And everything I'm saying is starting to get redundant, so I'm kind of just going to end this on this note. But definitely look up, definitely go on gamesindustry.biz, go to the article Charging More for Games Won't Rescue AAA by Rob Fahey, something like that, R-O-B-F-A-H-E-A, Rob Fahey, and read the article. Let me know what you think. Send me an email at info@b10.com, that's I-N-F-O, @b-ten.com, and let me know what you think, and I will probably feature you on the show. And we're also looking into doing a giveaway for next week. I'm not sure what we're going to be giving away yet, but hopefully that Steam sale hurries up so we can start giving away some Steam games over the show. I'm getting some donations in. If you would like to donate to b10.com, go to b-ten.com, go to the About section at the top, and donate on the little PayPal icon, I believe. Thanks for listening. If you or someone you know would like to join me on the show at any time, feel free to contact our email address that I gave you earlier, info@b10.com, It's info at symbol b-t-e-n.com. And have a good remainder of your day, everyone.
You should have got a better bed, better for your head, better heads meet your tie. You should have got a better bed, better for your head, better heads meet your tie. You should have got a better bed, I'm